Follow me.
Your Majesty, we have been traveling very far from the east. We've been following the star the prophets speak of. The prophets spoke of a child being born. We have come to worship this child being born, King of the Jews.
King? I'm the only king of this territory. Wise man, go to town, find this baby, this so-called King of the Jews, and bring him to me so that I may worship him.
Yes, Your Majesty. Come, let us travel.
Please give me some food. I'm starving. Please give me some food.
By order of His Royal Majesty, the Emperor Caesar Augustus, it is decreed that all the world is to be counted for and taxed. Therefore, let each person and family come to be taxed according to the law. So let it be written, so let it be done. Families, step forward and sign. Then the gates will be opened to you. Soldiers, open the gates.
Good evening. Welcome to the cloth shop, the finest in all of Bethlehem. I have been working on my loom, the only one we have in town. Because we've been doing such good work, the king himself has asked me to make some items and garments for him. And of course, I couldn't tell the king no. But as I was steadily working today, I had the strangest thing happen. A woman came into my shop and was telling me about another woman that had given birth to a child and had to lay her poor child in a manger. Well, of course, I looked around my shop and picked up some items of scraps from the king's clothes and gave her what I could and sent her on her way. I pray that that poor child is wrapped up warm on such a cold night. I thank you for visiting my shop, but I really must get back to work. But please remember, God's word says that she has no fear of winter for her household, for everyone has warm clothes. She makes her own bedspreads and dresses in fine linens and purple gowns. Thank you so much for your visit to Bethlehem and my cloth shop, and I pray you have a safe journey. Farewell, and I hope you find everything that you're searching for.
Welcome to the Mosaic Shop. Today we're working on a special project commissioned by the King to make a special piece for his tile palace floor. He's requested only the best, purples and reds, so we're using the grapes and pomegranates to stain our tiles. While we're working so diligently on this project, we're reminded of a verse in the Bible.
Deuteronomy 8:8, it is a land of wheat and barley grapevines, fig trees and pomegranates, olive oil and honey.
Oh, and this verse reminds us of how blessed we are by the Lord. Well, thanks so much for stopping by. We got to get back to work. But if you're ever in the market for the best tile in Bethlehem, you know where to come back.
Hello, welcome to the pottery shop. This is where all the king's maids get all their finest pottery from.
Our Bible verse is Isaiah 64:8. And yet, O Lord, you are our Father, we are the clay, and you are the potter. We all are formed by your hand. Have a great journey.
Hello, my name is Paul. I am a tin maker, and this is my friend Priscilla. She helps me. Right now, the economy is very bad, and everyone's having to pay taxes, and we are not able to sell many tents. But we will keep making tents because the great Isaiah the prophet tells us in 4:6 that it would be a shelter in the heat of the day. And what else did you say, Priscilla? A hiding place for the storm and the rain. So we would keep making our tents. God bless you and have a good time through Bethlehem. And would you like to pet my camel?
Why is your camel?
Hi, welcome to the spice shop. Spices are a luxury right now because nobody's really buying them, you know, because they're going to pay their taxes and all. But we're just going to keep trying to sell them. And Proverbs 27:9 tells us the heartfelt counsel of a friend is as sweet as perfume and incense. Would you like to take some spices with you?
Have a safe journey.
Welcome to the Starlight Delivery Postal Service, the only postal service in the city of Bethlehem. Most of the city can't afford our services. We are for the truly wealthy. Our typical Bethlehem residents have to depend on people passing through town to deliver their mail. But we promise you, if you use our services, we will get through. Neither rain, snow, or a broken down camel will stop us from delivering your mail.
Here, take this with you, and if you need our services, you can remember us along your journey.
Welcome to the Heart of Beauty Salon in Bethlehem. I'm a master, artist, creator. My work is to take something that's not so beautiful and make it beautiful. When someone comes to me and says, "Here I am, I'm in your hands, I totally submit myself to you, make me beautiful." So I go to work, cleansing, shaping, and cutting away all the old ugly stuff that's not supposed to be there, totally remaking. And what do I have? A physically beautiful masterpiece. But the news is, tonight in Bethlehem, a Savior is born. It said that He won't look on our physical beauty, that He will look on our heart. And when someone comes to Him and says, "Here I am, I'm in your hands, make something beautiful out of me," He goes to work, cleansing, shaping, cutting away all the old ugly stuff that's not supposed to be there. And what does He have? A spiritually beautiful masterpiece, a beautiful heart. And it's said that anyone that comes to Him will always be beautiful in His sight.
Welcome to the toy shop. Fun is always welcome here. You know, adults are paying their taxes, but kids still need to have fun.
Laughter is good for the soul. And also playing together is good for the soul. And working not playing sometimes is unhealthy. And we will fill Psalms of 126 too. We will fill with laughter and we've sung for joy. And the other nations said, "What amazing things the Lord has done for thee."
Welcome to my flower shop. I'm the only flower shop in Bethlehem, and I'm so glad to see you. You've come by to see me. I'm the only store in town, too, that has the Star of Bethlehem flower. So I'm so happy to show it to you. And also to tell you that Isaiah 48 says, "The grass withereth and the flowers fail, but the word of God always stands." Would you like to have one?
Welcome to the marketplace. We have the freshest fruits and vegetables in Bethlehem.
We're so busy here at the store that we're not able to go and get new dresses. Would you like a fruit?
We heard there's a rumor there's a baby being born.
Oh.
hot. Welcome to Bethlehem and to our bakery. As you can see, it's been busy this time of day. Everybody's coming in to pay for their taxes and do some shopping. They tell me my bread smells so good when they enter. And we just had to get some extra help here to keep up with the demand. I think it's my secret recipe, the bread of life.
Matthew 4:4. But Jesus told him, "No, the scriptures say people do not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God." Would you like a piece of our bread?
Hello, welcome to the Light of the World Candle Shop. In our shop, we make all the candles out of the finest wax in Bethlehem. Been extremely busy because there's talk of a baby being born in town. And always remember, on your journey to find that baby, that God's Word
is a lamp to guide my feet and a light to guide your
feet. Have a safe trip.
Welcome to the butcher shop. I'm glad you stopped in.
Have you traveled far? As you can see, we hunt, fish, and sell the meat to make a living.
Would you like a bite of beef jerky? Here's a card for you along your journey.
Welcome to the carpenter shop. There's a lot of people in town paying for the tax and census. Do you want me to build you anything? For every house has a builder, but the one who builds everything is God. Hebrews 34. Have a nice journey.
What seems to be the problem, ma'am?
My son, he has uncontrollable fits. He doesn't talk. He hisses like a wild animal. I can't control him.
Well, let's start with by praying for him. O God of Israel, I ask that you cast out the demons of this boy and heal him from all his sickness. Amen.
And they cast out many demons and healed many sick, anointing them with olive oil.
As a physician, I've taken an oath to put the life of the patient first. There's only one who can truly give life. He's come tonight to heal the wounds of the world. I wish you well on your travels, and I hope you find what you're looking for.
Hello, welcome to the music shop. We make some of the most exquisite instruments in the whole city. Even sometimes we make them for the king for his musicians.
Everyone has been talking about this huge star in the sky. Have you seen it?
Yeah, it must be something very special going to happen tonight. And just remember to always sing out your thanks to the Lord. Sing praises to God with a harp. Have a blessed evening.
Baskets, baskets, baskets. You need a basket. We have all kinds of baskets. Welcome to Reeds of the Nile. Our family has been weaving baskets for many generations. Why, even Moses was found in one of our baskets. All of our baskets are hand woven. No two are the same. And only the finest are here today for us to sell. We want you to remember that timely advice is lovely, like golden apples in a silver basket. Proverbs 25 and 9.
Hi, welcome to the jewelry shop. We have the finest jewels in Bethlehem. Would you like a jewel?
We have people from different countries to come to our shop for jewels. You yourself will be receiving several treasures as you go on your journey through Bethlehem. Please remember what Matthew says. Where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Enjoy your journey.
See this jewel that we have? Thank you so much. We're so glad you came. Welcome to
the. Are you ready to pay your taxes? Are you prepared to pay your taxes today, madam?
This is what I have.
Oh, no, no, that'll never do. One shekel for every man, woman, and child.
I'm just a poor widow woman. That's all I have.
Perhaps you have a goat or a chicken you can barter with?
I have nothing.
Must we go through this every year, madam?
But this is all I have. Please, please accept this. Please.
Who do you see on this one?
That is Caesar.
Do you not think it lawful to pay your taxes to Caesar?
I do, but please, please help me. Please take this.
Caesar will deal with you later. Do you think it's lawful to pay your taxes or not?
Exit this way.
Shalom and welcome to Bethlehem. With everybody being in Bethlehem for the census, our inn is just full to overflowing. We have people through on the roof, we have people inside, we have people on chairs, and even we even had to give our room away. And we even had to give to turn away a beautiful little couple, but the lady looked like she was about to have a baby at any minute, and we had to turn away because we didn't have any room. And my husband, he gets really, really irritable if we have to turn away customers.
What in the world is going on, woman? You're going to wake our customers. Can you not read this sign? We have no room. Life was good. And then comes the census. We had plenty of business, and now I have to turn people away. What about my reputation? What are they going to say? Why, I even had to send a woman great with child to the other end of town, to the stable.
What's all the noise down there?
Oh, now look what you've done. You've waken my customers. Away with you.
For a child is born to us, a son is given to us. The government will rest on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His government and his people will never end. He will rule with fairness and justice from the throne of his ancestor David for all eternity. The passionate commitment of the Lord of Heaven's armies will make this happen.
Good evening. What brings you out here on a fine, cool evening? Looking for a baby? This is no place for a baby. We have no babies out here. Maybe perhaps a baby lamb for a sacrifice.
Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
Come, let's go see this thing the angel has made known to us.
We're traveling to find the newborn King of the Jews.
We watched the stars as it rose, but now we're taking a break for the night.
We have come to worship him.
Behold, the birth of our Savior. It is the greatest season of the year when selfishness is subordinate to the desire to give rather than receive. Joy, love, kindness, and goodwill are among the simple attributes that make this holiday season so special. When Jesus came as a lowly babe, there was no room at the inn. Today and every day, every heart must bid him welcome. Christ came to give us peace and eternal life. Let us accept his gift with thankfulness, joy, and remembrance of his sacrifice. Let us always remember that most silent and holy night when God sent down his ultimate gift of man.
Here's your one, Eric.
No, she's like,
all right, here's the cool down one.
Ooh, that Whataburger. Come here. Splash.
This lady.
Hey, how are you doing?
Do
you want something?
I just, one thing I can't figure out is to go out here and see all this and major on the different imagination.
But the wise men say that it's true, about a virgin conceiving, a plan God was weaving to bring salvation to me and you. Now they tell me that an angel foretold it, that a prophecy was coming to man. All I know is something's going on down in Bethlehem.
There's something going on down in Bethlehem. A baby came to save the world.
Going on down in Bethlehem.
Can you say hi? Willie Jack, the escape artist. Yeah, that's a wrap, Willie. Say that's a wrap. Night in Bethlehem 2014. That's a wrap. Thank y'all.